Hey, good morning, good morning. Well, let me roll up the window. We just did our pre-trip. Now we just gotta wait until our time is up. And then we'll take off, run over to O'Hare, pick up our break, and head down to Hebron. Hopefully it's not as big of a cluster as it was when I picked up last time. I think I picked up on during the week, like I think a Friday. And man, that place was a zoo. Not that, I mean, it's main post op distribution center for international and domestic right at the post office, so I doubt it's gonna change. But you never know, it's Saturday morning, it might be a little on the lighter side. So we shall see. Wonder how many cars they're gonna have to tell them to move so I can back in to the spot. Hopefully I can get flipped around in there and park along the side till he's got my spot open. So we shall see in a little bit once we get rolling. Hey everyone, well we're at the post office, got here at 6:30, so far this one guy, you know, like I said, most of the people I ran into on the other side, I talked to two or three on the other side, they were really nice. This side, he's about the nicest. His other two employees, one doesn't talk to you at all or ask you anything, and the other one, it's rude as hell. Like, I was standing as far over to the left as I could, and they got wide steps. She goes, excuse me. Well, Jesus, how much room do you need? You're a small person. It's not like, you know, you're as big as I am, and you need that much room. She had 3/4 of the steps to go down. So I had to step sideways and give her the whole stairway. The first rude person I met, usually they're either quiet, she is definitely rude, and one lady that I seen last time said, no matter what you do, she's always rude. So she is definitely not a credit to the post office. This guy here, super nice. Second time, you know, he told me back in the same door as I was last time. He'll probably get me loaded, and if it takes too long, he'll apologize. Which he doesn't have need to do. Super nice guy. He must be the shipping tour manager. Super nice guy, and if his attitude's the same again this time, I'll compliment him again. Alright, we'll see you once we're rolling and headed towards Hebron. Good morning, good morning. Well, we are loaded and we're headed to Hebron. Well, one guy was there again. That guy has a great personality. You know, doesn't cop an attitude, and like the one girl on the dock making fun of the way this one lady laughed. I guess they have a little adversarial relationship. Same girl that told me, excuse me, and she had 3/4 of the steps. I mean, if you can't walk down with 5 feet in between me and the other one, there was more than enough. Jump 5 feet, it can jump 6 feet. Plus I had my mask on.
Turn left at the traffic light.
I should have went on my first thing. I didn't think they would get rid of the southbound exit for Mannheim. I could have just got off there instead of doing that loop around 294 and having to go across. Dated someone in Schiller Park, so used to run around here a lot. I don't know if you watched the last video when I was coming up Irving Park the other way. There's like almost no shoulders there. That thing used to have shoulders on both sides. The big thing when I was young, you come out here at night, park along the shoulder, and you just watch the planes go over. And they kind of got rid of that. I think there's a small one back there, but yeah, there. You could come on a Saturday night during the summer. Man, that shoulder, you could find a place to park on the shoulder. On either side, because there was guys out there with cameras, you know, family sitting out there just watching the planes go over. Even Mannheim doesn't have any shoulder. Well, there's a small shoulder here.
Take the exit on the right to I-190.
Put me back to planes taxiing to be unloaded. I think I've only been once on the tarmac here. I don't know if it was here or Columbus, where
in 1/2 mile, they, on the right, toward I-294 Tell South.
The company I work for had roller beds that they actually backed up to their machine. They slid it off the plane, dropped it down, and slid it right into my trailer.
Take exit 1D on the right, toward I-294 Tell South.
I guess you could say the coolest thing I had in the trailer is the company I worked for was shipping it somewhere else, but I had to pick it up. It was a prototype BMW. Hey everyone, how are you? somewhere about 70 miles north of Indy. Shows we're going to get to our delivery at 1:31. I'm showing I got enough fuel. I'm going to fuel at that Lowe's on 74 on the south side of Indy. That's about halfway to where I got to deliver. And then we'll be all set. Supposed to, I checked the weather. Supposedly, Kentucky's getting some rain now, which is a kind of a good thing, because the old gray wolf could use a little rinsing off. And when we get to next week, I have to allow Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday at least an hour in my schedule to, before I get home, to get a bath. And if I still got this trailer, I'll call up to get the approval to do the trailer at the same time. Get all some of this salt off and flash my aluminum and go from there. So far it's not bad, it's just windy. There's a nice, looks like it's coming out of the southeast. Depending on how straight south is it, 65 is here. Hey everyone, well, I'm at Forward Air getting unloaded. Shouldn't be too much longer, and then I'm headed over to the truck stop. So we'll see you when we get there. Hey everyone, we're offloaded and we're headed to the truck stop. Last time we get out on two, it's a pretty busy little highway. You gotta move just right so you can see in between the phone poles and see around that curve.
Traffic. traffic light.
Okay, we'll see what he gets me out of here. They're supposed to get between 6 tonight and 6 a.m. tomorrow, 1 to 2 inches of wet snow, so... But it's going to be warmer tomorrow in the 40s, so that wet snow is going to turn into water. Especially if it's sunny. But I thought they were saying that it was supposed to rain all weekend, but now it's in no rain. About 35 now, so it's probably, given that I don't know where the sensor is, so we'll give it like 2 or 3 degrees, so it's probably 32. Get that heater done so that I can stop spending money on fuel.